about Bill Buckner, and we're going to send this out to Bill Buckner. All right.
Lead on this one. When the star time. I don't know if I remember the words, but let's see.
Suspects. Oh, in 2007.
Sorry, go ahead.
Get your hand job.
Get your hand job. Great. 2007, Rock and Roll Hall of Fame inductees R.E.M. You're in store for a great show here. So please give a big Rock and Roll Hall of Fame welcome to Steve Wynn, Scott McCoy, Linda Pittman, and Rock and Roll Hall of Fame inductees Mike Mills and Peter Buck, the Baseball Project.
To be ignored, and they talk about the grave.
Does everybody know what box scores are?
Yeah!
You guys know what box scores are? That you shouldn't.
Oh, they should!
Everybody should know what box scores are.
That would be weird.
Well, you're gonna find out. You know, just a little way when they tell you what happened in a ball game. If you didn't see the game, you can look at this little chart and it'll tell you everything you wanted to know about the game that happened the day before. So, and I love them because they make me feel relaxed.
Okay, you should know that.
Was a bonus ending, sorry about that. Well, actually, I was so excited.
So, many baseball project, thank you all for being here.
Yeah.
I love the kids from day camp. Thank you. Amazing surf band just played upstairs. Thank you guys for coming.
I thought they were from the day camp.
Might be.
Sorry if we drowned you out up there, but it was really good.
Yeah.
Here's a little song about a guy named Lenny Dykstra. That doesn't mean anything to you. It's probably a good thing for you.
And don't ask the children if they know who Lenny Dykstra is.
He's in
you
jail.
You don't
want to
know.
Yes. He's in jail.
PG version.
About a mile from me when I was 24. If I don't know how much was still in store, because I want to know the man sleeps waiting for me. What do you feel as I could be never be? I live in a mansion.
The Red Bull Corporation, Incorporated Corporation, for that last one, thank you.
That's all. Rock and Roll Babylon. Red Bull. All right, this is a song about ball player Reggie Jackson. We sing about ball players, some who aren't that famous, some who are. I think a lot of people know him. And he, I was trying to think of like, you know, where the world's meet for rock and roll and baseball. And he's one of the more rock and roll baseball players because he was sort of full of himself, arrogant, had attitude, wasn't always on the mark, but when he was, it was pretty astounding. I think he's kind of like the Jerry Lee Lewis of rock and roll. Just
kidding. Let's go with that.
I'll be giving a seminar on a comparison at 3 o'clock, of course. I got a PhD in that. This song's called Straw That Stirs the Drink.
Walking in his bed, he's not around. He's like the wind, but that's not my
I am left to prove I want to and I hope.
I think that they shut the All-Star Game in Cleveland every year, and we should be a band here every four.
It's just a thought.
Came up with that.
Oh, you're a genius. Okay, here we go.
Now we're going to sing a song about a guy who died in Niagara Falls 117 years ago. As one will.
So enjoy. Losing his tongue. Lights on the road.
Thank you.
Ichiro. Ichiro, yes.
This is for our favorite pink haired ladies in the front.
Song to be singing, this is, I hope I'll never get in the Hall of Fame. maybe he'll get in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame before he gets in the Baseball Hall of Fame, that's possible. We'll see about that. It sort of takes a sentimental, apologetic view of the rock band called Twilight of My Career.
Twilight of my career. In the twilight of my career. Being a songwriter is that you get to address issues that matter to you, perceived injustices, which are everywhere in the world. Some matter more than others. This one matters to me. I think that Dale Murphy should be in the Hall of Fame. That's what I think. And I'm not going to stop talking about it until either they shoot me or they put him in there, one or the other.
Wow, time will tell.
Two MVPs and five goals.
sign stuff over here, the remaining dregs or...
The dregs of our fiefdom. Over here.
And we're doing a second set at 3 o'clock, so stick around.
Yeah.
Please do. Thanks so much. We're the baseball project. Thanks.
Musicians from bands including The Minus Five, Dream Syndicate, and of course, and many, many others, Filthy Friends, many others, including 2007 Rock and Roll Hall of Fame inductees, R.E.M. They are going to play a set here in a second. I just want to say it's been a great honor for us to host these guys here over the last 3 days. They've been the greatest house band I can imagine. For this week, so it's been great to have them celebrate All-Star Week with us. Please join me in giving a big Rock and Roll Hall of Fame welcome to Linda Pittman, Scott McCoy, Steve Wynn, and Rock and Roll Hall of Fame inductees Peter Buck and Mike Mills, the Baseball Project.
Henry Atlanta Braves.
Yeah!
Thank you. Thank you. Harvey Haddix and perfect game pitchers. In the first 110 years of Major League Baseball, there was only 13 perfect games thrown. And Dennis Martinez, El Presidente, threw that 13th one.
Okay, we're gonna leave you with this one. This is a real upper. We're gonna leave you on an upper. So thanks to everyone for, some of you came to all of our shows, all 3 days, even all 4 days. And we just appreciate you all so much. Thanks, and we'll see you next time.
Thank you for watching Cleveland Live Music. If you like what you see, hit the subscribe button. There's Patreon and GoFundMe information in the video descriptions. Thanks for watching. Thanks for making the channel grow so much.